Hello everyone, this is Jordan from Traders Terminal, and today we're going to talk about Bitcoin halving. What is it and how it might affect the future prices of Bitcoin, given that the next halving is going to take place in a few months. It's becoming a really hot subject, and everyone is looking towards this event as a possible trigger for another bullish run. So let's go over it and see what we have here, guys. So what is the Bitcoin halving? Halving is an event that occurs roughly every 4 years, or in other words, once we get 210,000 blocks. Okay, every time we reach 210 blocks, 1,000 blocks, of course, we're going to get halving. And that means the rewards which miners are getting are being cut by 50% every time this event occurs. Currently, the reward that miners are receiving equals 12.5 bitcoins per block. So in May 2020, so in a few months' time, the reward will drop exactly by 50%, which means 6.25 bitcoins per block. Now, in total, we have 21 million bitcoins, and that means already over 80% of that total supply is in circulation, or it was mined, right? To use the slang for that. And this is a very small table that represents what happened with Bitcoin and the rewards in the years before that. Now, at the beginning, once it was introduced, for every block that was mined or produced, miners were getting 50 Bitcoins. Then the first mining occurred and it dropped to 25 Bitcoins. Currently, miners are being rewarded with 12.5, etc., etc., etc. Eventually, at one point, when we reach halving number 32, there will be zero Bitcoins reward because all Bitcoins will be in circulation, they will be mined, and then the rewards will be in different ways, meaning that you're not going to receive bitcoins immediately, you are just going to receive tiny portion of the fees which are being charged when there are transactions. Okay, so it will switch from one model to another model. Now, that being said, let's move on to the next slide, which is, I'm not really sure the source of this one. Many people claimed for the source, but whoever the original creator of this one is, thank you for that. Again, this is not my creation, so credits go to the person who created it. But important part here is to see how and what happened to the prices of Bitcoin after each of these halvings. So as we said, at the end of 2012, we got the first halving, and you can see this sharp move to the upside. It's important for us to mention that this is not happening overnight, guys. All right? Because there are many people who are currently taking the side of basically the price of Bitcoin is already, it's called pricing in, right? The given event, which means in anticipation of some news or whatever the event is, participants jump in expecting positive outcome of the given event, and the price is driven up before the actual event takes place. So many claim that this has already happened with the given decline or the pullback, which was approximately 90%, and from around 3,000 we reach 12,000, let's say, right? Again, rough numbers from the top of my head. So they believe that event, the next halving, which is going to take place, was already priced in. We're not going to see immediate reaction. Well, all due respect, but we can see what happened previously. After these big drops and big pullbacks, look what we have. We have sharp rallies, kind of sideway moves, and then after the halving prices, well, in this case, it's not very gradually growing. Here we had a very powerful boost to the upside, but next time that happened, it was more gradual move up. Okay, and you can see we're reaching kind of the top after 500 days. Here we got to the top after approximately 1 year. So again, it's not just overnight event which is going to shoot the price up and then it stops. It takes time for this thing to work in reality. Now, as we're approaching to the given date here, which is supposed to be somewhere in May 2020, we can see we're looking at this rally. The initial phase of the rally right before the halving event, just like we had before that, right? So that makes a lot of sense, of course, as history tends to repeat itself. And whether this is actually going to provide a bullish market afterwards, only time will tell. But all the factors we can see before historically tend to point to this direction. Now, once the halving happens in May 2020, the supply rate will drop in half. This is a fact. So that means the network processors or the miners will be rewarded their bitcoins in a gradual and controlled rhythm, since the rate at which bitcoins are mined and introduced to this ecosystem, of course, is reduced by 50% again every 4 years approximately. The model used in Bitcoin more or less copies the way physical gold works, guys. That's why, well, this is of course one of the reasons why many people refer to Bitcoin as digital gold. That means we want to keep the inflation rate stable and predictable. So you have a total fixed amount of coins, just like we have a total amount of gold, right? Gold is not unlimited, and it becomes harder and harder for the companies to mine it and to even find it. So this is more or less the way how Bitcoin works, and the more coins are mined, the harder it becomes to get to the new coins. Okay? Now, on the next slide, we can see the Bitcoin inflation rate in percentages. And you can see how this rate is dropping. And eventually, Bitcoin will also reach 0% inflation rate. Okay? That, on the other hand, means we have a deflationary currency here. On the next slide, you're looking at the technical analysis. Now, this is based on the Spotlight algorithm, which is provided by the tradersterminal.com. You can find it there. And as per the last update, this is the long-term forecast, which is based on weekly, daily, and four-hour chart. We see that Bitcoin has already switched up. Right? We are in strong bullish market, and currently we have pullbacks. And the recommendation by the algorithm is to look for buys. So, considering all the facts above, and knowing that Bitcoin is a deflationary currency, meaning that it increases in value over time, Should we spend our bitcoins or store them as an investment? What's your opinion on this one, guys? And here I want you to think about two things. If no one is actually using it, the currency becomes kind of useless, right? Because you need adoption. And thinking about gold, because we mentioned gold before, gold is widely used in many sectors. So, what's your view on this one? If everyone buys Bitcoin and stores it in order to cash out at some point when the prices are really high, etc., but no one is actually spending it and using it, right? What we call the adoption phase, what happens then? So, looking forward to your comments on this one. It's a really interesting subject. And that would be all. Thank you for watching.